Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 things you may not know you can do with the calculator app on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, the calculator app on your Mac seems pretty simple at first, but there's a lot of advanced functionality built in. I'm going to launch it here using Spotlight. So Command Space and then search for Calculator and then launch it. But to have easy access to it in the future, I'm going to go down into the dock and drag it from the right side of the dock to the left somewhere in here. So now I can just launch it with the dock in the future. So it looks like a normal calculator, but the first thing I'm going to show you is something that no normal calculator does. And that is allow you to delete the last number you pressed. So I'm going to type a number here and let's say I make a mistake. And I want to clear that last digit. On a normal calculator, you would clear and start over again. But you can just use the delete key on your keyboard and delete the last number. You can go all the way back to the beginning. And another thing you can do since you're on a Mac is you can use copy and paste. So I can do something here, get a result, and if I simply use edit copy or command C, I can now go into another app, command V or edit paste, and paste the result. You can even paste into Calculator. So I could type a number in another app, select it, Command C to copy, go to Calculator here and Command V or edit paste, and we'll paste that number in. So now I can perform a calculation without typing any numbers. So I'll multiply and then select this number, Command C to copy, Command V to paste in here, equals, and I get the result from the numbers I copied from a document or web page. Now sometimes when you get a result like this, you need to go and type it in somewhere else. So if the number's long, you end up glancing between here and whatever you're typing into. But you can go to speech and have it speak result if you want.
Speech enabled.
And now whenever I do a calculation like this,
1107,
it will speak it. And you can also have it speak everything that you press on the calculator.
1, 2, 3, plus 9, 132.
Another thing you could do is show the result larger and in the middle of the screen. So I'll put a number in here and now you have to two finger click on a trackpad or right click on a mouse on the number here. It doesn't work if you control click to bring up this context menu. For some reason that doesn't work in Calculator. But I'm going to use two fingers on a trackpad and you can see I get large type. Select that and now it puts it large in the middle of the screen. Now while this calculator looks really simple, you actually have three calculators in one in the calculator app. You can switch to one of the other calculators by going to View and you can see Basic, then Scientific and Programmer. So let's switch to Scientific. The keyboard shortcut is Command 2. And now you get a scientific calculator. So this might be more what you're used to if you have an advanced calculator. And you even have more functions than this because if you hold the Shift key down, you can see some of them change to alternative functions. And then you can go to Programmer Calculator. And you could see a different set of functions here, ones that would be useful if you're a coder. You could even switch between bases, 8, 10, and 16. You can show or hide the binary version of the number that's here. You can show the ASCII code or Unicode of whatever the value is. And you can use a bunch of common logic functions here. You can also switch between the basic calculator and the scientific calculator by hitting the green button here, which works a little different in Calculator than in other apps. So it just switches between basic and scientific. If you want to go to the programmer calculator, you have to use Command 3 or View Programmer. Now when you have a calculator like this, you may not know what everything does. Instead of having to look it up in the help or anything like that, you can simply move your cursor over it and wait, and you'll get help text that shows you. This works for some and not for others. It does work, it seems, in just about every one of the commands here in the scientific calculator. There's also a pretty good help document if you go up to Help, Calculator Help. That explains a lot of the functionality of the calculator. It's worth a read. Now one thing that this calculator app does that almost no regular calculator will do is do conversions. So you can enter in a number and then you can convert using all these different types of measurements. So for instance, if I wanted to convert length, I can convert from feet to meters and we'll do the conversion for me. You can see there are a lot of different types of conversions here. Most notably, there's currency. So you can convert from one currency to another and it will actually call out to the internet and get the current rates. So let's convert dollars to Japanese yen. And you can see here the last updated value and where the data is coming from. Convert, and you get your conversion. The convert menu also has recent conversions here at the top. So you don't have to keep looking for a conversion that you're doing all the time. Now a really cool thing that the calculator app does is paper tape. So go to Window, Show Paper Tape or Command T, and you get this little window here. And everything that you do will appear here in the paper tape. So you have kind of this running record of all of your calculations. And you can go in and select things to copy and paste results into documents or back here into the calculator. You could even go and print tape and print this out or save it as a PDF. But if you want to use this in another document, one thing you can do is click in here to select, then Command A to select all, Command C to copy, and now you can paste it anywhere you want. Now a calculator also does something called reverse polis notation. So you may have learned this in college. If you go to View and turn on RPN mode, it will now give you this stack here and you can keep adding numbers to it. So if you're not familiar with reverse polis notation, it allows you to do things where you can control the order of operations a little bit more. So for instance, if I wanted to do 2 plus 4 times 5, I could do it where I do 2, enter, 4, enter, 5, and then I have those numbers there in the stack. I could multiply the last two, 4 times 5, with multiplication to get 20, and then add 2. Now last thing I want to show you is that there are some keyboard shortcuts that can come in handy. If you go to Help, Calculator Help, we looked at this before, but here we've also got a lot of keyboard shortcuts at the bottom. So these will work even if you're not in the right mode for them. For instance, you can use the caret key, which is Shift 6 on a US keyboard, to bring something to a power. So you would normally do this in the scientific calculator and say if you wanted to do 5 to the third power, you would do x to y, 3 equals, and you get that. But you could use the keyboard shortcut of caret to do it. So we'll clear that out and we'll do 5 and then shift 6 and then 3 equals 125. The cool thing is that I can go back to the regular calculator and use that same keyboard shortcut. So 5 and shift 6, 3 equals. So I can access some functions even if I'm not in the right calculator mode. You can see if I do shift E, I'll switch to exponential notation. If I'm going to calculate the natural log, it's the E key, and that will work even though I'm not in the scientific calculator mode. And even P will give me pi. That last one isn't even listed here in the help, but if you go to the scientific calculator, move your cursor over pi, it'll show you. You can press P. So while a lot of us, including myself, like to use Spotlight to do calculations, or even Siri, there are still a few things that the calculator app is handy for, especially if you like using a calculator and you like doing calculations in that kind of app. You'll find that the calculator app that comes with your Mac is actually pretty powerful and capable of doing just about anything that you need. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.